So, GGG just released a new patch notes. Let's take a look. Before starting this recording, I watched this list and seen some interesting changes. So, let's look here. What took my attention from the first glance was this one, Legion. And I'll explain you why. I also did a guide how you can get fast levels here in the domain of Timeless Conflict, Legion farming. And I explain you that this way you can get to level 100 in one day. In few hours, in 8 hours, in 6 hours you can get, you finish the campaign, you go to Blood Aqueduct to level 68, then you go here, you go in Legion runs, you can buy them on TFT Discord or in trade channels, and you can get in 6 hours or 7 hours, depending on the runner, to maximum level 100, which was very overpowered, you know, people were leveling in Legions. If they wanted to reach level 100, they didn't play maps like a crazy guy, you know, they just ran Legions, they bought Legion services, this changes everything. Read here, the Domain of Timeless Conflict has a minimum area level of 80, if you don't know, the lower the area level, the less XP you get. And read here, specific Timeless Emblems and Relenting Timeless Emblems no longer provide additional area levels. So you don't get extra levels, they were nerfed. So read here, additional, așa. 4 emblems increased the area level by 1, so 81, and 5 emblems increased area by 2. So if you do 5 ways, which 5 ways means 5 emblems, you get area level 82. This is a nerf. here, each unrelenting timeless emblem, for those who don't know, this shit is this one, let's see. Because many of you don't know. Is referring to this, you can also apply these ones. So if you want to apply this shit also, you get more area level, but look, if you put this shit, you'll have area 84, and this shit have low drop chance. Keep in mind, the 20% increased experience gain for each timeless emblem has been removed. Oppo. This means, basically what, I will translate to you simple. They nerfed 5 ways, and you can't level to 100 effectively here, no more. Which means two things. First, on TFT Discord, people will offer less these services because there will be less buyers. Buyers cared a lot about the experience, which will also affect the Timeless Jewels, boys, because the Timeless Jewels will get more expensive. Because in the past, people bought these runs, so the runners were inclined to do as many runs as possible, meaning they had an influx of Timeless Jewels. Now, less people will farm this shit, Timeless Jewels will bump up in price. So yeah, Timeless Jewels will be expensive. We'll see how this goes. This will change a lot of things in the new league. This is the biggest, this change here is the biggest one in this page notes. This shit here will affect the whole league. It's very important because many players use this service to get to level 100, to get to max level. Also, those runners had an influx of jewels on the market and everything will change. Yeah, so again, this is the biggest change. For those who don't know what 5 ways are, let me put you a clip right now. It's from my video. Come on, take big loot, bitch. Let's see if they pick it. Come on, take it. Well, these are rich guys. Okay, we are getting closer to the next level. In this pixel madness. In this horrible pixel madness. Okay. You know, if you show someone gameplay footage from this, we'll say, what the fuck is this game? Looks horrible. Yeah, you need to explain. Well, this is something special. Okay, so we reached level 95. Pretty fast. Yeah, pretty fast. Took me like 15 minutes. I'll pause here and continue. Another change that I like a lot and I find refreshing is this one, Torment, the Torment Spirits. At the moment in game, the only note that makes this league mechanic interesting or good is this one. I take it a lot of times, you know, up to 5 rare monsters in each of maps are possessed and their minions are touched. This will give more loot. You know, usually there's a pack and some small monsters. Everything will get possessed, so they drop more loot. I use this strategy when farming Crimson Temple. They drop more loot, more chance to get the apothecary. But now, things change a little. This is huge, because it will make Torment farming something useful. Read here, it's very important. Torment spirits have up to 560% more life. This is important, but usually when you met a spirit in your map, you one-shot it because it has few life. Now, you won't get one-shotted. Why this is important? This is a great change because now Torment spirits will die hard and you can get possessed. They explain that now in the new league, Torment spirits can possess you. You can take these options and you benefit from the attack speed or all the modifiers that they give, usually give to the monsters. You will get them. In the past, some players took this one moment. This one. Read this line here. You can be touched by tormented spirits. So in the past, people would equip this helmet, and when they see a green tormenting spirit, they would rush into it, so they get touched and get all the benefits. There was a problem. So okay, so in the past, the torment spirits got one shot. They would die very fast, and usually by the time you reach the spirit, it would die. You know, depends on your build. If you play Righteous Fire, for example, the torment spirit would die instantly. I'm kidding, but the idea is, now the torment spirits have much more life, meaning they won't die fast. So you get this effect, which will be very interesting. I think many players will experiment with this because we want to have fun. This is the main idea of the game. We want to have fun. Don't want to plan all day in battle building or shit like that. We want to enjoy the game. We want to make currency. We want to have fun. This is the main idea of the game, and I keep repeating. Another change that is worth mentioning is here for the Atlas passive 3 change. The first one. Shaping of the Sea and Shaping of the Valley Atlas notable passive skills have been removed from the Atlas 3. If you don't know, last week I made a full guide for League Start progressing your Atlas. And there in that guide, look, I kept, this is the tree from the guide. And in that guide, I didn't took these two notes, but I explained, you know, if you want more chance to get to one tier higher, you can get Shaping of Seas and Shaping of Valleys. But, you know, for me it's very funny. In that guide, okay, I explain how I do it. Usually I go for Kirog missions, then I go for some map chance and strong boxes. And I explain you in that video everything why I do this. But it's very funny. They removed this point that I didn't took, and some of you in the comments start yelling, oh, you need to take Shaping of the Valley, Shaping of the Sea. And I explain, no, I fully unlock my Atlas by day 2 doing like this. If you want more chance, sure, you can take this shit. But I think GGG infiltrated my YouTube channel. Sinu, look, PoE guy doesn't take Shaping of Valleys and Shaping of the Sea, and they adapted to me. They say, oh, we need to remove them from the game. And they seen my video, okay, GGG came to my video, they seen I didn't took these notes, yeah, and they removed him. They removed him from the game. You see, this is the power of true understanding of the game. I didn't took in the guide these two notes, GGG removed them. So we do it the right way. Go watch the video if you want, because it's very interesting, especially if you're a new player, and you will learn a lot of things the right way, because you don't want to get bored, you want to have fun and learn things. Let's move on. Another thing that got my attention in the patch notes are the map changes. You know, each league in Path of Exile, there is a huge map pool. Each league, they rotate this map pool, you know, they remove some maps and they add some new maps. Some of you, maybe you don't know. So in this league, we get these maps and we lose these maps. Okay, what I noticed, the first thing, because some maps can drop some jackpot divination cards. We like to farm Apothecary, you know, and what they did, if you see here, they removed Defiled Cathedral, which is one of the maps that got, this map gets farmed a lot. Many players farm Defiled Cathedral. They remove Crimson Township. Can it Crimson Township? They remove this shit. Few players farm this because the last boss is a pain. The last boss does some weird sounds, you know, blah, 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 and one shots you, you know. When you get to the last boss, he says some curse, he curses your family, blah, 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 and he one shots you. This boss is broken, they need to fix this boss, you know. It's still bugged, you know. So you go to the boss, he starts yelling, blah, 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 and he one shots you. Okay. The interesting part is they didn't remove the Crimson Temple. And I'll explain you why, because they wanted to remove it, but they were at the meeting and they say we can't remove Crimson Temple. Why? Because people will start complaining, you know, people when you remove their content or they modify their perfect builds, they start complaining, you know, mommy, they modified my build, you know, they cannot adapt. When they did the nerfs to the loot drops, a lot of players started complaining and yelling, mommy, they nerfed the drop chance, mommy, I have less loot. No, but they don't think these changes affect all the players in the game. I was very upset, but I didn't have a YouTube channel at that time. When they did the massive loot nerfs, so this affects all players. So don't be egoistic things in terms of yourself. This affects all players, meaning the meta of the game changes, the economy changes, the prices changes, and the players adapt. Okay, well, I deviated a little. Okay, so when something gets removed or changed, will affect all players. You're not the only one. So the entire meta of the game will change and you need to adapt. This is how you do it. And it's more refreshing because you can play and try different play styles, you know? You don't need to play fucking Righteous Fates each league because other build you know how to play, you know? You need to adapt, you need to think fresh, or something like that. Okay, I'll stop here. I'll stop here because I see I'm like a volcano, you know, which it's erupting. Now I'm a volcano that's erupting. Let's move to the next... What I'm saying here, they kept Crimson Temple because players would start complaining because they like to farm powerful divination cards. In Crimson Temple you can get the Apothecary. If they had removed also Crimson Temple, you see they removed Crimson Township, Defile Cathedral and also Crimson Temple. Let's check. As you can see, Crimson Temple is still available. This, they were very scared because people start bitching around, you know. That's why they left Crimson Temple, so people don't complain like a crybaby. Let's move to the next one. Another change that I like a lot and will impact a lot of players, especially noob ones. So if you're a new player to Path of Exile, you might want to go Blight. They added it Keystone, where we talked about it already. Deal less damage to the monsters that spawn in the Blight event, but your towers will do 300% more damage. This is a lot. So basically, I will translate you like this. You have a shit build, your build sucks, you put the Keystone and you focus on the tower strategies. Because there are some strategies, you know, you put some freeze tower here, some ground here, and the monsters get slowed because there are some strategies here to kill the monsters very fast. I will also make a video guide about Blight because I enjoy this league a lot. It's refreshing to see such mechanics in the game. Basically, this is a tower defense game. You know, this Path of Exile really added some interesting side contents, you know. This one is the most interesting to me because it's a tower defense game. Also, you have those Blight Ravage map, Blighted maps that are solely based on tower defense. Also, there's one more change that I noticed. Let's open this sheet. No. We Blight here. This one. No. Okay, this one. Says here. So in the past there was a Atlas skill points that gave towers and minions in your maps do 20% more damage. Now you have this, Blight monsters in your maps take 12% increased damage. So you can take this Atlas passive points and pair it up with the Keystone. So basically just put towers and everything dies. If you have a cheap build or your build sucks or you're a very new player, you go Blight, you take that Keystone, you focus on the towers, you will watch my new guide on Blight, and you will own everything, and you get the loot, and you get rich. You do it like this. This was not a big patch notes, you know? These are not many changes. But the changes that have been done will impact the game. You know, the keystones that have been added in the Trail of the Ancestors, also the Legion farming will be nerfed. All these little things add up and will change the league drastically. The game is pretty cheap at the moment. Yeah, you only have to buy a few stash tabs and the rest game is free. So let's not have a lot of pretensions from this. Game is great, new league will be great, a lot of changes. Good luck and have a great league starts.